attack. So again, just hitting those S tier picks, and Azir banned away from Bjergsen as well.
Yeah, Azir off the table. Okay, that probably means they're not going to have a surprise Vel'Koz pick in their repertoire then. So close the door on that one, but everything else pretty still, so pretty much wide open. Vladimir, Ryze. Pretty similar band so far. They don't want to let Haunter have that Swain. However, Haunter is a really big fan of Aurelia, as well as even still Echo. I mean, Echo did get nerfs, but still decent. So curious to see if we'll ever see him pop back up.
Yeah, we saw it hovered by both of the top laners. We know they both play this Echo, so that could be a potential pick that we see them sort of flex around. Caitlyn is going to be the last ban. Once again, keep Apollo off of that safe AD carry. Now it's up to the first pick for Apex. There's the Aurelia hover. We were just talking about it.
Yeah, early Aurelia picks should be common. I think they'll become more common because she has a lot of really good matchups. It's hard to counterpick her. But it's going to be that jungle focus, you know. No Nidalee on the ban list. There she is. Shrimp going to take that one up pretty quickly. I'm actually a little bit surprised because for me, the first pick, Nidalee, has really dropped down in priority. After not only the nerfs to her, but also Rek'Sai fills a really good space right now, I feel like. And it, if you have a full tank Rek'Sai, it does your job for vision as well as the early pressure that you want, and then also enables your top laner to go really hard on either solo one versus one builds or some sort of other damage aspect from the top side. But if Nidalee is going to be your jungler, you might have to be a little bit more conservative.
Now this sort of gives us a bit of insight into how Apex are going to plan to play with Rey. The fact that they do have the high damage Nidalee might mean that Rey will have to take something a little tanky to sort of go with
cats and dogs.
Yeah.
No. Nasus.
Well, currently.
That would be sick, but not going to happen probably. Kindred also not going to happen because they already have a jungler, but we didn't really mention the Karma pickup here. Steal away. Going to take away Expecial's Karma for Biofrost. He's also had success on this champion. We talked about his Bard previously, but Karma was also strong. Pretty easy to execute as well, the Karma. Definitely lower skill cap than Bard.
Yeah, once again, the Freljord in bot lane. Good engage, good in team fights, good peel for that Ashe.
And again, this theme that we've been bringing up of a lot more utility from the bottom lanes showing up here for Apex. We'll see if Apollo can fire off more arrows early on in the game, maybe, or if the team actually can try and play around those arrows and actually look for the picks and get into position to capitalize on some, mid-game arrow pickoffs. Plus, obviously, the Braum is going to add some extra disengage as well.
Yeah, he did land a lot of arrows in the previous game. Specifically
hit
on
double lift a couple
double
times.
Lift, yeah. So on that same Lucian as well. We'll see how that works out as TSM are looking for their next two picks. They already know they've got to go up against the just as mobile as Kindred Nidalee for Shrimp. But Victor is going to be locked in for Bjergsen. Not going to save that counter pick for Bjergsen. Instead, they're giving it over to Haunter.
Yeah, I mean, Victor, really easy blind pick for mid. So they'd rather have Haunter be the counter here. Show top lane first. They're forcing Apex to show their top lane now. And allow Haunter to actually get an advantage in this matchup versus Rey. Let us see. What shall it be? Because they've got such a rounded team comp already, with the utility from bottom lane. Kennen's a pretty good hover right now. Did get some buffs in the mage rework that haven't really talked about since he hasn't been picked up. But he did get slight nerfs. Doubt he'll be locked in here, though. Might be something more along the lines of maybe Ray's Shen that they showed earlier. They want to make another go at that, but it looks like they would lack some damage in that case.
From one ninja to another, but in fact, it's going to be ninja to troll. Trundle locked in the top lane for Ray, and Keen returning to that Zillion.
All right. So they're definitely going to have a lot of pressure in the top side, no matter what matchup. Talk about blind picked champions here. Trundle's fine into most melees. Actually, all melees. I'll go ahead and say that. Absolute. Can throw him a curveball there, though, every once in a while. If you get a ranged champion and try and apply some jungle pressure, try and abuse him. If you do get the first blood on him, if you do get a splashdown in an early gank, then try and mess with him a little bit more.
Yeah, what's the good of subjugate if there isn't a tank to shred?
We'll follow a king that gave up first blood.
Yeah, exactly.
Not I.
Okay.
All right, no surprises, though. Back to the standard. Ray Fizz, it looks like.
Well, Haunster's going to be taken at this time.
Oh, whoa. Reversed. Not
yeah.
the standard.
They did swap sides, Kobe.
Hmm.
I
all
know
right.
they're still sitting in the same seats on stage, but in-game, we're swapping over.
All right, well, Fizz is one of those melee champions. Isn't going to have as hard a time, but I still give the edge to Trundle here, so...
Mm-hmm.
Maybe there'll be a lane swap even looking around.
Yeah, we'll have to see. The Lucian Karma, a very strong lane. And we actually saw the Ash Braum played earlier today into, I believe it was Karma and Sivir, which was very harass oriented. So all game, Keith just had to run around and avoid the harass that he was going to be taking from that duo lane. So lane swap could be very strong. And Apex looking to crack the impenetrable shell of TSM's win streak.
Mm-hmm. Who will be the first to take game off of the new squad? Again, really big discrepancy that's going to jump out, you know, is going to be the mid lane teleport. Bjergsen on the Victor. He's facing a lot of crowd control. The Ashe on the other team is very scary, so probably take cleanse on that mid lane Victor, which does open up, you know, Ash Arrow plus double teleports for your team. Crumbs mentioned on the analyst desk, you know, these are tools you can use to try and make some of those mid-game plays cross-map and, you know, get an advantage for yourself.
Yeah, stack a Braum in there for more CC. But make your voice heard on Twitter. Tell us who you think is going to win this game right here using hashtag APXWin or TSMWin as we get ready to go into game number two. TSM 5-0 in games, currently 2-0 in matches, looking to make it 3-0 as they take us onto the Rift. Will Apex be the first team to take a win off of TSM, or will TSM continue to dominate the NALCS?
For a whole 2 weeks.
Yeah.
What a streak.
It's still a domination.
All right, well, invade here looks like it's brewing for Apex as they're congregating mid lane. They do have Braum, so anytime enemy team has Braum, you best respect. Nice. Animation canceled there. Shrimp gets the kill. Ray has a giggle.
Yep. He's
and,
just having a jaunt.
They are going to get the deep wards down here for that lane swap.
Wow. Ray is very bold. And Haunster, in fact, is going to recall deep wards for TSM on bottom side. Apex have got deep wards on the top. And currently, Ray is actually headed down towards the bottom side.
Yeah, gotta be careful here.
Minions have spawned.
Playing with fire, Lucian Karma lane is very, very oppressive. Especially if you make a wrong turn early game in the jungle, level one. You, even just one Monstrous Q before minions spawn, and you know, combo there from double lift is a huge chunk. So they have to be careful while also trying to feel out the early game movements.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody going down towards the bottom lane, though, so double lift and Vile Flash will find themselves in the lane swap, and they won't really get to go aggressive early. Just take away the enemy Krugs, which is slightly aggressive, I guess. Count it for the TSM duo.
More golden experience, while TSM are going to go with a double jungle as well, and that means that Apollo and Xspecial are going to be safe in this laning phase. Ray, in fact, is actually going to head down towards the bottom to catch up with that duo, Haunter. I see the Fizz, and I assume, yeah.
He's not yellow, though.
Yeah, oh, you're right. Where's Ray, and now Shrimp are going to head towards that lane swap and look for those early birds. And Skaren, though, is going to get a few more camps across as well.
Yep, pretty standard here from both sides. Then going to move down through red, join up with everybody else. Mid laners both hovering, as you can see, to their respective sides of the mid lane that are controlled by their lane swaps. Keen on top side where everybody is. Bjergsen going to hover bottom, so I don't think there'll be any early ganks on mid lane, and it's the fight over minion wave clear. Currently Keen dominating that matchup with bombs.
Yeah, red buff is secured by both of the junglers. as Double Lift and Biofrost continue to look to break down that tier one. So
there's a small interesting wrinkle in this lane swap in that the Infernal Drake is the first Drake right out of the gate, and it might encourage them to actually go for an early Drake because people are so enamored with the Infernal Drake. And it looks like they are going to spend a lot of time going for it. Apex actually are the team that loves Riptailed buff the most, though. So they might try and get over there for the spawn of it. Keen also knows about this dragon now, trying to zone them off, and the Infernal Drake doing that large amount of splash damage chases TSM off. So good stop there from Apex.
Keen is able to scare away TSM as Shrimp, in fact, invades Svenskeren.
Telling you, people are a little bit greedy when they see that Infernal Drake.
Oh, Shrimp got it with the auto. Didn't even have to smite.
So close.
Is that Infernal Drake greed going to cost him his life, too? No.
Oh,
just a bit of his jungle, but that is two camps out of the jungle, unless Double Lift gets down here to defend the wolves. Shrimp now has smite, so going to be able to get that one also.
Double Lift is going to clear out one. An special is over the wall, so could be able to hop to Shrimp's aid if necessary, but Apex are able to respond appropriately and scare T away from that early objective. Standard masteries all across the board.
Yeah, pretty standard. I guess for Fizz, the fervor is now standard. Grass, I mean, there may be a matchup where you want to take grass for the extra healing, just trying to sustain through it, but for the most part, that fervor, especially going to allow you for the late game team fights to still destroy the back line, even with mostly tank build. So
yeah, that's
really been emerging with those nerfs to grasp as also huge top lane popularity.
We'll see if Onser decides to follow with the same Trinity Force double stun in the mid lane. As everyone continues to play nice and calm. Keen, you can see the player portrait. He playing with his, what is that, his right leg up?
I mean, he's gonna have, Ray's gonna have both legs up here when the Rek'Sai knocks him up. And
there's first blood for Svenskeren. TSM, gank top. Ray already being shut down. So TSM already looking to play a little bit differently. You can see two wards on the top side of the map.
Well, I mean, kind of glossing over how that whole setup there, you know, big wave getting shoved in, low health Trundle as well. That's definitely a big oversight here from Apex, and Svenskeren coming up for a very nice dive. Pretty big for TSM because, you know, Ray is the guy they want to play around, and Apex before that had been doing really well. They're still in the gold lead because of the early game, even after the first blood money goes over to TSM. So that was actually a crucial play for TSM. As we see the recall from Nidalee, and Ray takes a huge chunk in that trade with Haunter. Huge! Look how many ranged minions there are. It's almost double digits of ranged minions, plus the cannon really did a lot to him. And then they go for the blind dive. It's actually kind of a risky dive because they hadn't seen Nidalee. And it does pay off for TSM to get them right back into this game.
Yeah, it looks like Shrimp has been hard farming the rest of the time. Currently level 6, nearly 20 CS ahead of Svenskeren, but that first blood is going to help Haunter in that matchup against Ray, as there's the harass bottom lane from Biofrost and Double Lift. Continuing to farm it out, while blue buff is gifted over to Bjergsen in the mid lane. He's going to go catch up with Keep.
Yeah, give him over the blue buff once again. But yeah, I mean,
they're going to fight over this. There's the Chaos Storm onto Shrimp. He is taking a lot of damage. There's the Chrono Shift.
That's going to time out, buddy. You are in a very...
Oh, he doesn't make it over the wall.
Not today, my friend. Pretty costly mistake there.
Monster's looking for another kill to add to his belt. Now looks for Ray. Some good damage. Damage amplification has fallen off, but Ray is healing up nice and slow.
Yeah.
He's got flash as well, and Ray is going to be solo killed by Haunter.
TSM strikes back. They had a little bit of a hole to climb out of because of their Infernal Drake greed, but that mistake there from Apex up top side, and then in the jungle, invade, just kind of snowballs against them, and TSM take control in a very big way now. Two mistakes cross map here, and Shrimp goes super greedy for this blue. All ins to steal it away, and then fat flash face plant into the wall. Feels bad, man.
8.5 minutes in, TSM have already got 3 kills. As Svenskeren responding appropriately in the top lane and in his own jungle with double blue control for TSM.
I feel like they still had their eyes on that Infernal Drake too. TSM like, all right, we're gonna be all right next time now. We got a couple of kills. We're trying to beat back Apex and regain control. Ray is in a really bad spot. Hunter almost coming back up. Oh man, Svenskeren's actually recalling. Doesn't even want to go for it. He could just straight run through that pink ward. Like, if Hunter just lands point blank ultimate on him, they could have just closed that. But yeah, they had to wait another, 15 seconds on Haunter's ultimate to come off cooldown, and that's too much time for Sven.
Yeah,
got moves to make. I'm out of here. Gonna go cross map. Continue my farming on Rek's side. Get back in this.
He does
got those 2 kills to catch it back up.
He's
but
got
Ray
a tunnel up there, and he's on his way. Ray is going to eat one big burst of damage. Here comes Svenskeren. Still no flash. And Ray, despite the subjugate, is going to drop another kill for TSM.
Yeah, see, you could have. Svenskeren could have just walked that way and done it. and then use his ultimate down to the bottom side where he can continue farming. But he's just on that farm mode. And then Hunter makes the call probably. He's like, this guy is in my zone. We can kill him so easily. Point blank ultimate. Back off cooldown. And he's toast. Who will TSM close on next? Because they're looking like they do not want to lose a single game here. Shrimp now cornered. He might be the one next marked for death.
Yeah, there's going to be a knockup. Bjergsen right on top of him. Drops the Chaos Orb onto Keen. There's the Chrono Shift onto Shrimp. He's going to be locked down. Firefrost is getting ready for the snare. There's the knockup. Bjergsen gets the 5th kill for TSM.
TSM, 5-man mid. There's the Infernal Drake reward. They will finally get it. Started off at like 3 minutes to come back to finish the job.
Took 7 minutes and 5 kills, but they finally have earned themselves that Infernal Drake.
Have they, though? The volley steal from Apollo incoming? No.
Let's not get too overexcited now.
Well, not much else for Apex to get excited about, because Ray on Trundle getting blasted is a very bad sign. That's all that Trundle does, is go solo lane up there. If the Viz has advantage, then it's going to be rough going for him. Shrimp, though, on the wrong side. Teleport did cut him off, and Grixon tries to go for the double kill here because Keen uses ultimate early on Shrimp, but Keen's able to walk himself away, and it's just going to be that one kill. TSM, though, very, very handily in control of this game. Infernal Drake's the best Drake for snowballing a game where you already have a lead. They earn themselves that lead. There's the Drake. Next one coming up is actually going to be a mountain, and that's really good for finishing out games. So,
TSM right now have got everything going their way. 5-0. They might be losing this bottom tier one, though.
Yeah.
They decide to trade for the top.
Good call there from Apex. You don't want to fight anymore. Start trading objectives. You know, get some of that mid-game gold for everybody. Try and hit it. First item breakpoint is what you're looking for, and nobody even really has completed anything except for Keen here. So, trying to just stall out a little bit now for Apex. They're not that far behind. We make it sound really, really bad. After this turret does go down in answer, it's going to be, you know, about 2,000 gold. But man, Apex, they can't afford to lose much more. They're going to need to make a big Ash Arrow play.
Trying to make a play on the bottom side right now. Xspecial is going to eat, chum the waters and take a lot of damage. Arrow finds Haunters. Oh. It seems like Apex might want to try to turn this around. Spear brings him to half.
This is TSM defending, though, with double lift split push farming. He's able to get free minions down bottom, or up top, I guess. Plus, he's going to be able to take out this turret, so TSM defend their secondary. Double lift down there, he's going to be able to put some damage on it. I think they're going to lose sight, and he might have to back off before killing it, but...
Oh, Xspecial eats a chilling smite. He's got exhaust and is able to hop to safety. Bit of a greedy recall, but he still escapes, and now TSM might be looking to collapse mid. Bjergsen pressuring forward along with Svenskeren and Biofrost. Instead, they're just going to try to deny Shrimp's jungle a bit.
Yeah, on the other side, Double Lift is also stealing away the blue buff on the Lucian. So cooldown reduction, bunch of mana as well for the semi-spellcaster. AD carry here feels pretty good. Can he finish it, though?
Oh, Shrimp is right there in the spear. Bjergsen is the one who's going to finish it off. Double Lift looks to complete his recall.
Hands it over to the mid laner. What a team player, that Double Lift guy. Hands it right off. And TSM, there's Ghostblade for him, so they're hitting the item points as well that they can really push this home.
Yeah, this is a very swift game from TSM. Smite used by Shrimp to secure away that Raptor cap.
Dangerous game here, sticking around this red buff. I think Svenskeren, you know, they saw the Warden here. He's baiting them to come try and counter this red buff here because all of TSM are in position to collapse. And Apex don't take the bait. They semi take the bait,
yeah.
And Expecial at least.
He's gonna have to run out of this and arrow, find Svenskeren. The volley slows a bit. Expecial takes a lot more. He's gonna go down to Double Lift.
Yeah.
The sixth kill for TSM.
They've still got two more. They're chasing. Looking ahead of him off here. It's just an Ash. She does that flash.
Yeah, Svenskeren decides to let her go. All right, 14 and a half minutes in, TSM. You know, you used the word earlier in the game. They look so clean in this match. Just controlling.
Yeah.
Just about every single lane. Controlling the jungle, preventing Apex from really doing anything to get back into this.
Yep, conveniently start up their Rift Herald. Oops, Haunter's like, I aggroed Rift Herald. Better kill it, guys. Give me that buff. And that's just going to further spell doom for this Trundle. 0-3 Ray Trundle versus the Sunfire completed already for Haunter. He's got the extra level on him, and it's really easy for Fizz to all in with the mobility that he has around this point as well. So pretty difficult situation for Apex where they can't rely on their split push threat. Mm-hmm. They kind of have to put everything on an Ash Arrow pick now at this point, and bursting someone down before the rest of TSM show up. They really need to isolate somebody, kill them, and then get right back out. They can't overstay after they catch somebody either.
Now, right now, Apollo catching minions in the mid lane while Keen goes for a recall. That's going to leave Haunter split pushing in the top lane while Apex try to get that Ash more gold. Get more damage so that the arrow can buy time for the rest of Apex. 40 seconds now for that Mountain Drake. Second of the game, and Apex are contesting vision around the area. Double Lift is already down there, and TSM, well in advance, are collapsing.
They do have some wards they've been able to move in, but I feel like taking a fight at this point is going to be very detrimental to your team health. TSM are significantly ahead. Plus, they have the speed to chase down.
Yeah, Shrimp forced to flash away.
That's going to reduce the probability of an Apex Dragon Steal as well, because Shrimp can't jump in there and try to flash out. So TSM chase him off despite the decent amount of vision work.
Oh, there's the arrow, but it's well in the back line. Bjergsen's going to eat the damage.
All right, no flash on our jungler, no arrow from the Ash. I think you can see this one. It's just a Mountain Drake. That's not really a good comeback Drake, so TSM probably racked this one up free.
Yeah, they have now started it. Recall being initiated by Haunter. He's going to try to catch Ray, who's been split pushing in the top lane.
They're making a move. I mean, Apex are trying it for a cross-map move. Everybody's going to take a long time to head up there, but they want to make a press and try and get some global gold back for that Mountain Drake at least. See how fast they can actually damage this turret, though, because TSM are in the area trying to collapse. There is a ward for Ray to teleport. Look at this pink ward in the river, by the way. It's a long way behind Apex, but he can get behind him, and he's going for it.
Yeah, he's teleporting right now. TSM charging forward, and Apex see that this is happening. Keen is coming forward as well. He's going to have to run through the team as
got
he split off. It's 5 versus 4. The fish is going to find Shrimp. Exhaust denies some of the damage, but TSM charge in. Shrimp is going to get the chrono shift, but that means Keen is undefended. Apollo gets destroyed by Bjergsen while Svenskeren is in the back. Haunter is shielded on the front side, and TSM are cleaning it again through another auto attack. Bjergsen isn't done just yet.
Run, Keen! Tell the story of the Apex members who have died before you.
He's got no walls. Fence Garrett's going for it. Oh, there's the Chilling Smite and knock up. Ace for TSM. It's 11-0.
Woo, that is going to be a full ace there for TSM. Everybody's dead. Team kill for TSM. They should be able to take this turret as well. They don't even want it. Leave that sucker behind. They're going to recall, I guess. Set up maybe for the 20-minute Baron spawn right on the dot. I mean, you got a lot of options here as TSM. They already have vision in the blue quadrant. There it is. That's the ward we were talking about in the river to point out. Ray heads up there. Actually, Ray's holding up the caboose here, and Haunter gets a free shot. This fish. Shrimp tries to protect the ball there. You can see he takes it for him, but Haunter's right in the middle. He starts tanking, and this is the only real scary point for TSM was, oh, will Haunter die while we kill the rest of the team? He gets down to one more hit, able to Q to the other side, and Biofry shields him. So the answer is no. TSM clean 5-0 here as they chase down the last member. And even Zillion, warping time, cannot escape the Prey Seeker. Found ya.
There's the Chilling Smite. 11-0 once again for TSM. That's about a 4,000, 5,000 gold lead. They've got two turrets right now, two dragons. Next Drake is going to be the Cloud Drake. And they are all prepped around that Baron pit, though. Haunter is split pushing on the far side, and Ray does have his teleport.
Yeah. So the small thing that Apex can at least take to heart is that it's a little bit difficult for TSM to actually pressure in the turrets. So Apex do have the option to turtle, but they're not turtling.
Bjergsen is going to try to burst down Keen. The Chrono Shift should keep him alive, but Xspecial will drop to Sven Skaren. Haunter joins the fight a bit late, but just in time to find Ray. He's going to be knocked up and secured by TSM. 13-0 for Team Solo Mid, and now they've got that Baron.
Baron on spawn is a very rare thing, especially in competitive, but TSM are going for it here. For Apex, this has got to be the hero play. If they're going to make a comeback here, this is their opportunity. Zillion teleports in. Ash does not have arrow, but he can walk.
Yeah, there's a lot of damage. Double bomb is going to miss. TSM sitting safely in the pit. Haunter is chunked out. Baron is secured by TSM. Double bomb finds Haunter and the volley. Oh, there goes the perfect game.
Haunter's gonna go try and zone, quote unquote, for the rest of the team, even though Apex were backing off and gets bombed up there. That is gonna be the morale boost for Apex. That's what they needed. They're on the board, boys. Is it, Dom? Is it what they needed?
It makes them feel better.
It's one thing. They need about 20 more things on the list, though, and that's a long grocery list.
6,500 gold, two dragons. TSM already setting up vision for the eventual Cloud Drake, and now they've got Baron buff on the 20-minute mark. Currently, looks like they're going to head towards the bottom lane as Double Lift and Biofrost going to try to get some deep vision into Apex's territory. Looks like Apollo and Shrimp are going to look for an arrow. The arrow finds Biofrost, fear to follow it up. Double Lift looks to turn it around, but Biofrost is already dead. There's a culling, and here comes Sven Skaren looking to get revenge for his fallen support.
I don't think they can get it, though. Biofrost gets nailed right there. It's nice skill shot accuracy, at least, on the standing target for Apex. Get another kill back for themselves. Hey! So one more thing on the grocery list. Now there's only 19.
Yeah. And mid-tier one is going to go down in the meanwhile as Bjergsen clears that out. Keen sitting safely under that tier two while Haunter and Ray continue to keep themselves occupied on that top side of the map. Here comes Bjergsen now looking for that tier two turret. Continue to press into Apex's territory and try to shred through these turrets.
Well, minions are chipping away. I don't know about shredding, but TSM blows on another kill.
Yeah,
they don't even care about Steve.
Oh, he's going to be knocked up. There's another kill for TSM, 14-2, and they find the top tier two in a rotation.
0-6-0 for Ray on Trundle, and that is Rip also getting knocked up. Can they jump inside the base?
Haunter eats another stun. Double Lift uses a culling. Looks like they might just look to break this inhibitor, and they have found about to do it. There goes the knockup from Xspecial. They need to finish it off, but they don't have any minions. And there goes a flash. Arrow is going to hit double lift. That's a huge stun. Heal keeps him alive. And TSM are able to back off.
Woo. So they are focusing pretty heavily on kills. It's about time for TSM to focus on finishing out the game, though. 23 minutes in, they barely get out this time around without double lift dying. But yeah, they're pretty much closing the loop here. So if they actually calm down a little bit and move up the wards, you know, and try and pressure side lanes, they do have teleport ready on Haunter, so they can react to anything. And in a straight up numbers even game, they'll easily be able to bully out Apex.
Yeah. Well, sometimes that's the solo queue mentality. We are so far ahead, we can get away with anything.
Well, they're looking for more kills here. Double lift and Sven Skaren close in on bottom. They've got him pinched. Ray looking to go 0-7.
Oh, man. He's taking a lot of damage.
No assist.
No assist
didn't
for
even get
Sven
it.
Skaren. That's another kill for TSM.
Oh, man. That is bold. You go Titanic Hydra when you're 0-6-0 Trundle instead of going full tank. Well, unlucky.
Yeah, Baron buff has now fallen off, and TSM are breaking the bottom tier 2 now. The only person to defend up here is Xspecial, though Apollo will finally cash up. Not quite enough minions to continue making this an effective siege, but on the far side, Haunzer is putting some pressure on to Apex's base, and with Ray dead, there's no one who can answer.
True that. Very few answers would be correct here. Right now, Apex really setting up the bombs, trying to defend the Alamo.
Yeah, oh, the fish is going to miss right now. Subjugate was used. Haunter is
taking
a lot
Ray.
Of damage.
He's trying.
Ray is doing a lot.
He's
can
doing
he
it.
Burn him down? He flashes. He wants this
oh,
kill.
Oh, he's doing
Haunter
it.
Is going to juke back around, and oh, he goes down.
Success. Ray gets a kill for himself. 0-7 Trundle. Solo kills Haunter.
It paid off.
Woo! And TSM leave the base standing still. So,
yeah.
I mean, all this focus on just nabbing kills for TSM, they have left the base intact for Apex. Even though they're facing a giant gold deficit for Apex, at least they're getting kills every now and then.
Yeah, 25 minutes in, TSM are up 9,000 gold.
Yeah. So we talked about cleanliness before, Dom.
Yes. Well,
that entails, you know, finishing out the game in an efficient manner, I think. A reasonably efficient manner, right?
Yes.
Everybody, you'll give them a couple gimmies. Okay, you can dive a couple turrets. You're that strong. You know, you get an extra kill or something. But at a certain point...
It seems like they're just leisurely playing this out now.
Yes. Definitely a little lackadaisical in their approach to the ending of this game. Open inhibitor on the top side. It's them spreading out. They're almost as far away from each other, everyone on the team, as they could possibly be. But they still have complete control of the game, so you get freedom to do whatever you want at this stage in the game.
But Kobe, have
this is America.
Have Apex found out the secret sauce to beating TSM?
No.
Let them relax by getting them.
This does not look like it. If this is a very diabolical secret sauce, like this is.
I'm trying to paint the picture that TSM have some semblance of a weakness in some sort of situation, even if it is when they're up 10,000 gold.
Go back to art school. Not a very good painter. Job.
Okay.
Oh, solo down the bottom. Let's take a look at that sucker again. This is cool. Here
like
we go.
Haunzer
here we go.
Revenge.
You want some more, Haunzer?
There's the subjugate. And Ray heals it back up. Haunzer knows not to fight around that buff. He's actually taking a lot of punishment now.
This is what you call testing your limits. Now they're just curious.
Yeah. I wonder about these numbers.
Can I take this? Looks like I still can't take them.
Arrow is fired and is going to miss. TSM, they've got double lift splitting in the top lane. Could be looking to break down that first inhibitor of the game and finally crack open the map. Apollo trying to dissuade TSM, but Sven Skaren and double lift will not be stopped unless more of Apex arrive. There's a stun.
Haunzer's just getting teleported in. He's got a home guard sitting in fountain right now. They need to drop a deeper ward for him, though.
And knockup is going to find Bjergsen, but Sven Skaren is just running bodyguard. Double lift is exhausted. He's pinned and is forced to dash through the pillar. Haunzer does TP in. He hops forward onto Xspecial. Xspecial goes low and is going to go down. And this might be TSM finally looking to end the match as Apollo eats a huge amount of burst. Hanser goes two Nexus turrets deep. He's finally going to go down to Keen, but the inhibitor is down, and it's currently 4-3.
I'll take those odds if I'm TSM. So will Ray, actually. He wants another piece. He's emboldened by his success against the 1-1s. And, well, a little too bold there from Keen.
Yeah. Keen reenacting his impression of Laud from last night. Gets destroyed by TSM, but Baron has now respawned, and TSM are already on it.
That's going to be the buff. Let's see if they actually decide to go for a kill after taking it, or, you know, recall and trying to end the game. They can just recall, wait for Haunter, five-man push, Baron buff up the minions. Oh, here comes the...
Wow! Double lift kill. Bjergsen. Absolutely destroy Shrimp. Baron buff is secured, and TSM continue to chase forward. Another kill for double lift. This is a happy day for you Fantasy LCS
too.
Members. Svenskeren dashes forward. Triple kill for double lift. And TSM, might they finally push for the Nexus and end the game?
Yes, Dom. I'm going to answer that question for you right now. They will stick around. Hunter's heading up the middle as well, so. Ooh. 5-2. No abilities, no money, no base.
Yeah, this is the Nexus going down. TSM are going to go for a few consolation kills. Nexus is laid bare, and TSM are finally going to drop it after picking up a few more to make themselves feel better. Ray's actually trying to get a bit greedy here. There's the Nexus. TSM are undefeated, both in matches and in games, 6-0 and 3-0 in those matches. Can anyone bring down this team?
I mean, they haven't played everyone in the league yet.
Yeah,
so.
They played three teams.
But still, can anyone? Because they actually do look like the best team in North America right now. There were some questions around maybe Immortals, but you know, if you look at the gameplay here, just. They have dominated their opponents. TSM have absolutely crushed all opposition that they've come up against thus far. And they look really, really hot right now.
Very solid play from Team Solo Mid. Apex having a lot of difficulty in this series. Their second loss of the weekend. That's going to put them in the middle of the standings, 2-2 right now. Mm-hmm. Looking forward to see if they can grow and adapt over the course of the next week. But Team Solo Mid... so very strong, looking so even casual as they walk by the fans. Yeah, another day in the office.
Yep, happy to go to work today. Come away winners, and that's a pretty quick finish as well. We'll definitely be able to check in on the other stream on that series as well.
Yeah,
I think Cloud9's still going.
Yeah, not 100% certain. Let's talk a little bit about what worked so well for TSM. The fact that Svenskeren was all over Ray during the early game.
Yeah, I mean, there were some mistakes here from Apex. They were handed like a really strong tempo advantage. When TSM had that Infernal Drake greed, they wanted to go for it early, they got chased.